It's Matt Martin, Outdoor Designs. Sorry it's been a couple weeks since the last video. Just craziness going on in life and in work. My wife and I moved to a new house, so been busy trying to get the move completed. What else has been going on? Oh, aerating and overseeding started up, and wow, how much fun that's been. It's been a little bit of a disaster to start out, so that's really what the gist of this video will be today, is going to be aerating and overseeding. And the issue that comes up is going to be timing. So you want your ambient air temperature to still be hot enough to speed up the germination process. What you don't want is, you know, to have your seed come up and then all of a sudden we're having days back in 95 degrees and, you know, 77, 78, 80 degrees at night. That just is going to lead to a whole host of issues and ultimately cause your seed to fail. So it's finding that proper balance between high daytime temperatures, cool nighttime temperatures, where you get the benefits of having warm soil temperatures for the seed to germinate and cool enough nighttime temperatures to keep the seed from frying. So anyway, that's the battle that we've been facing. So we went for about 4.5 weeks of no rain, and trying to start aerating and overseeding has just been a nightmare. Breaking tines, you can't pull a plug, you beg people to water and they do water, and you still go out there to aerate the lawn and you can't pull a plug. I mean, it's been that kind of a start towards aerating and overseeding. I've even had a few top dressing projects where I've gone with, a real low-end compost, mushroom compost. It has next to no N. And it actually has burned the crap out of some yards. I'll throw up a picture of one of those yards that got burned. So that's been the struggle out of the gate. Now, to our advantage, we just got about 2 inches of rain on Sunday. So that's going to help us big time moving forward. At least these next series of lawns that we start aerating and overseeding, we're going to be able to pull a solid core. And the hope is that we continue to get rain. Irrigation is only a supplement, and this is something Pete and I talked about several times. You know, irrigation is a supplement to rainfall, and without rainfall, the turf is never going to perform. So that is what we need to happen. Watering is going to be nice. Yeah, it's going to keep the grass going, but really rainfall is going to set the lawn apart. So with aerating and overseeding, you'll see here, I'll throw up a clip of my setup for this year. This is going to be my last year using this setup. I've got the four-wheeler and the pull-behind Klassen with a bunch of Versalock brick on the back of it strapped down. And I've got my little Klassen split drum walk-behind aerator. I'm probably 30 something yards into it, and I'm getting the crap beat out of me, and the poor guy that's helping me, he's getting the hell way laid out of him too. So anyway, last season using that before I buy a ride on aerator, but that's what I'm going with. So to start out, I'm running I had never, the years I've been doing this, I've never heard of certified seed before. This is going to make me sound super rookie, but I've never heard of it. And this year, it's funny, the first pallet of seed I got in, it was blue certified seed. And I was like, oh, that's great. Now I see what we were talking about. And it's a blend of three fescues. And that's what I've started going out with. Right now, I'm putting down a 16-4-8. That's 50% ammonium sulfate, 50% PCSCU, with chicken poultry as the filler. So that's basically what I'm gonna throw down for all my aeration and overseedings. From this point forward, after I get through with all the aerating and overseeding, my plan is to run a maybe a 20-0-10, I think is what I'm looking at. Finishing throwing out is that the 20-0-10, that's like, I don't know, to the ton. It's got like 600 pounds of chicken litter in it. And then I will probably close out the year with something. That's pretty high nitrogen. So I may go up with like a 3505 or something like that. That's, you know, 50% slow release or something like that. Maybe 30% slow release. So anyway, you know, this is where, you know, you're here a couple different opinions on how to handle the turf grass. From here moving forward, most homeowners are going to be under the impression you aerate, you overseed, you put down your starter fertilizer, and you leave it alone until next year. Yeah, you could get away with that, but it is probably not best to get away with that. You know, you're going to have to continue to feed that grass. The starter fertilizer is really just to make it as green as possible when it germinates and jumps up. So, you know, I have mixed opinions. You know, is the grass going to germinate any better with or without starter fertilizer? Probably not. It's going to germinate the exact same way. The advantage of putting down the starter is that you're probably going to get a little bit more mature plant a little quicker. That's going to be able to tolerate environmental extremes, and it's going to be more aesthetically pleasing as the plants do reach maturity. So that's your advantage there of running a starter fertilizer with your seed. You know, some people get hooked into the 18-24-12 thing as far as the starter fertilizer is concerned. I don't. I'm not a big phosphorus guy. The whole reason I'm running this right now that I have with the phosphorus is that it's been treated with it's been impregnated with a chelated micronutrient package, and I used it not this spring but the spring before, and was super super happy with the color response I got from it. So my goal this year is to have the yards as deep green as possible leading into Halloween, because I feel like Halloween is going to be a show-off point for the lawn, you know, where you have people over and, you know, you're proud of the way your yard's looking, you know, come Halloween. You should be, at least. And so I really want to set my yards apart by Halloween. And I think this fertilizer is going to give me a good start on doing that. So yeah, that's what's been going on. I've been super sick a little bit, and moving into the new house and aerating and overseeding starting up. I got the young guy working for me, Jordan. You'll get to see plenty of action shots with him. My dad got me a drone for my birthday, so you're gonna have some really cool drone footage. I've always wanted one, and now I get to bust it out on the job site and torture my helper during this aeration overseed period with lots of screen time in front of the camera. So anyway, y'all, it's aerate overseed time. This is when this is the biggest part of our season. It should be the biggest part of our season revenue wise, and this should be the biggest part of our season as far as making improvements to the lawn. So anyway, the time's upon us. Embrace it while it's here, because it doesn't last forever. And this is when you really get to become, you get the moment where these new customers are going from zero to hero really quickly. All right, y'all have a good evening. Thanks for everything.